everybody, this is Pam at the Paper Outpost, and today we are using up some book pages and greeting cards. There's so many different things that we can do with greeting cards, and I thought I would show you another example. So here we go. Let's look at the prototypes. Okay, so basically I used cards similar to these, and I made these two examples. First of all, this one has a book page on the front, and I just tied a little piece of lace around it. And I'm calling these the trifecta cards now because they have three flaps. One, two, and three. And you can put anything inside here. You can put word inspirations, stickers, poems. Here's more stickers, just an example of what you can put in here. You could put numbers, you could put quotes, you could put, it could be a little story that goes in three parts, like, hello, I love you, Sally, something like that. So many different things that you could do with this. I've gone ahead and edged it with washi tape so that the edges are nicely sealed together, and I'll show you how I did that. And I backed the back of the card with some coffee dyed paper, more washi tape, and this is the fold over from the front of the book page. So that is example number one, and she has a little lace tie. And then prototype number two has a little gold stretchy elastic with a little piece of jewelry on it, which easily is removed. And the orientation of this one is from the side. So this one will, this one was this orientation, and now this one is going to be this orientation. This is the normal orientation of the card. And it also has three openings with three little flat back pearls to denote that there's something to do there. And a little word at the bottom. It's also edged in washi tape, inked around, and it has some stamping on the back on with avocado dyed paper. Okay, so now on this one, you open it up and it says, fresh as the dew on a daisy. And I thought that went with the this style theme of these vintage ladies. I thought they were so beautiful with their bicycles, boots, and beautiful hats and dresses. And I did some stenciling on this side. And then at the very bottom, I put a section of Edith Holden writing or printing actually, and just inked around. And that was a lot of fun. I did put a piece of old stationery, not old stationery, it's a new stationery, but I cut it out to fit on this page. And that way there's some journaling space if somebody wants to journal around. You could not have anything here, but I thought since we had the three doors, maybe I'll call these three door cards. That might be easier. There we go. So very easy, very simple. Another great way to use up cards. So I will put these two prototypes aside and we will make some. Okay, so I thought I'd use this card today, and it's a big card. It doesn't really matter what the orientation of the card is. It just matters how you'd like to design it. And this one happens to be blank on the inside, but if your card has a sentiment here or has pictures here, they can all be covered or masked very easily. And I will pretend that we have some things here. So we will do some masking, and I will make it I have no idea what that was. I'm going to make it similar to this style. Okay, so we're going to do some stenciling over here. We're going to put some stationery here and maybe put some words here. I found some old magazines that have bigger words in them. Magazines are a great place to get larger font. So if you want bigger words, look in magazines. Okay, there we go. You can get magazines at the thrift store too. They still sell them there, believe it or not. All right, so let's do the back first, and or the outside first, I should say. And let's see what we have here. Okay, so I'd like some text. Actually, that's what I'd like to work with. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to glue this down. You can use any old glue you want. I am going to use the Scotch Create glue stick, multi-purpose permanent glue stick. And I'm just going to glue it. All right, so here we go. Just gluing around the town. Here we go. And the desk today is good and messy. That must mean that I had a good crafting session last night, which I did, and all is well. All right, I think I have enough time to get this on there before this glue stick dries. This is a very strong glue stick. And I would say probably pretty much any glue stick will work for this project. Doesn't have to be a super heavy duty because we are going to reinforce the edges. And there, okay. So I'm just just gonna close it up so it stays nice and fresh, and I'm just gonna go ahead and put this down. Now this one I would like the font because I want to put some things on top of it. Although it does have some nice pictures, but for another day. Okay, actually I can just take these in two. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put, okay, that's there. That's what I'm gonna do. All right. Okay. Now this one, let's see, I'm stuck, help. Oh, is it too late? It might, see how fast it grabs? Yeah, it starts to grab really fast. Okay, so that was a little too soon. Hey, that's the way it goes, let me throw that out. Okay, what we're gonna do, we're gonna pretend like that never happened and we're just gonna carry on. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Okay, so now this part at the top here, I could fold it over and that would be fine, but I think I'm going to use our old friend sanding block, and I'm just going to shave off these parts because I want a nice sharp edge here where the spine is. There we go. Oh, so much excitement already. The day has barely begun. Where will we go with this now, huh? I have to rethink and think on the fly here. That's okay. I think on the fly all day long. We'll just grab another book page. That's what we'll do. Okay, let me see if I can get you off. All right, whoop, there we go. All right, so let me grab another book page. Where are ya? Okay, I found a Oscar Wilde plays book here, so I'm gonna take a page out of here. I'm gonna take a page out of this book, and I am going to figure out which is the front and back again. I think I still have enough time to glue this down. And I'm gluing. Okay, there we go. There, just mushing down using the old hand tool. And that, I think that kind of looks actually better. It's got two different colors of paper and it's kind of pretty. So I'm gonna go with that. Now I'm just going to finish off my edges to make them be smooth. Okay, have I got enough glue there? Oh yeah. And I am good. So now I just need to tear away the borders. And for that, I will use my very famous ever tearing ruler as soon as I can locate it. Here in the pile somewhere. There it is. Okay, not too far. This is not officially a tearing ruler. It's just a metal ruler. It happens to have a sharp edge and it just makes it easier to tear. So I'm just going to put it along here along the sides of stuff that I don't want, abutting it against the card itself, pushing down firmly and tearing all that off. Whoops, looks like more than I wanted came off. Okay, that's okay. That happens too. And it's just one of those days. Oh, these are great words. You know, when you see words like that and stuff, save them because you can use them on places. This is a plant book. And I'm gonna try that again. See if it works this time. Maybe it will, maybe it won't, never know. But we can always ink around the edges, and that's a great way to, let me back up. Let me just lift this up a bit so you can see a bit better. Deal with that if that happens to you. And here we go. Let's see. I'm gonna go a little slower, a little more carefully. Oh, no, back down you go. Different paper. Switching to different paper now. Okay, so this one. Okay, how'd we do that time? Not bad. Not bad at all. Okay, and I have one more little edge. All right. And these are okay to be thrown away. If you want to keep them for scraps, that's fine too. But we only have one more little edge to deal with. And the good news is, and why everything is okay here, is we're going to be, okay, here we go. Hold your breath, everybody. Big test. Okay, firm, push, grab. There, okay. Well, not like, okay, I did fair. Not great, but this paper is extremely fragile, so I'm thinking probably that's what's up. But either way, it doesn't matter because we are going to cover the edges with washi tape. Yes, let's see what we have here. We have some cats. We have some, let's see what would be pretty. Let me get one. Hang on. Okay, I found three. They have greeny brown color, and I think that would be good for a, I'm going to put some nature-like pictures on here. So I think maybe I'll use this one, and this is how I do it. So this is the inside of my card. This is the outside. I'm just making sure that I have my font, my text oriented right way up so that I just remember what right way up is. Okay, but it doesn't really matter at this point. I am just washi taping it. So I'm gonna grab a big piece longer, just as, a little longer than my length here or my width. And I put it down about halfway, squish it, pick it up, use itself to fold it over. And that makes that. And then you're pretty much done with that. And you don't have to worry about all these little tiny edges that are weak and that are going to peel away on you. If you're unsure about your washi tape at all and you feel like it might come apart, then glue it down. Use a little bit of glue. That will give you certainty and nothing will peel up on you. Sometimes washi gets old. I've heard that you can microwave it to soften it up. I've never tried that, but somebody mentioned that that is a way to reactivate the glue. Haven't tried it, but just tossing it out there. All right. And lifting it up. Oop, don't need you. And folding over. And good. All right. So I am just going to do this to all four sides. It's a very easy technique, and it's a very pretty way to give yourself a little frame. And it makes everything nice and strong. So it's cold here today. We have real winter. Yep, very frigid. And was a little nippy on my walk this morning. I had a winter coat on. Yep, I did, in Florida and all. So we are doing the back and forth weather thing here. But it's kind of nice for a little variety. I call them mini seasons. Yep, mini seasons. I never know whether to, you know, put my sweaters away yet or not. But hey, it's only January, so I don't mind a little winter. That's kind of nice, because when we get our summers, boy, we sure get our summers. All right, one last one. Doop. And a great way to use up the old washi bucket if you've over-collected and feel like you're actually using up your supplies, which is awesome. And I think that should be, it's great to use up what you have. Let's try and focus this year on using up what we have before we run out and buy tons of stuff. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to use up more of what I have, and there's no shortage. So there you go. Okay. So here, I'm going to call this my front, and I'm going to call this my back, because that's just the way it works out. Now, this edge looks a little naked, so I think I'm going to ink it so it sort of matches the rest of the feel. And I'm inking with walnut stain distress ink, and I'm not feeling distressed when I have my distress ink. And it's funny how we have words that, you know, mean different things. Would you say that's a homonym? I think that's a homonym. They sound the same but mean different things. I think a synonym are two. Wait, that's another word for, right? Yes, yes. I can think of a synonym. You know what I mean. Give me examples of synonyms, everybody. Two words that are different words, but they mean the same thing. Okay? All right. Okay. I should have looked one up. I didn't know I was going to be talking about synonyms today. All right. But yes, there's lots of synonyms out there. Now, you can ink your washi. Washi is a little bit of a waxy masking tape sort of feel. So it may stay or it may not. Depend if you have the drier stuff, some of it has a drier finish, some of it has a waxier finish, but just hewing it down a little bit, just for the hue of it all. All right, so I have some leftover scraps here that I would like to use. And let's see what else. I had another page here. Oh, yeah, here. These are pages from field guides, and I just love using field guides because they have a lot of illustrations of birds and plants. And I just think it really looks cute. Okay, so now how you orient it, it's totally your choice. I think, well, just anybody on the back there that I need to know about? Oh, you guys are pretty too. Oh, so hard decisions. Okay, we're going to take the big main focal picture here. We're going to tear. Just got to decide. And I have more, I have a lot more field guide pages, so I don't have to worry about running out. And you can get field guide books at your used bookstore, at your thrift store. I think Abe Books and maybe Thrift Books USA, I think it's called. eBay. eBay is a great source for field guides. Probably Amazon would have used field guides, too, if you want to get used ones. But there's lots of them out there. See, that looks pretty already, doesn't it? Now, of course, it needs a little zhuzhing. Can anybody spell the word zhuzh? I was trying to explain the word to my husband. I said, you know, dear husband of mine, I said, yes, you know, another word like to, you know, throw some bling on something or make it look more amplified or distinct or pretty or something is zhuzhing it up. Like you zhuzh your hair up at night when you're going out or something, you know? And Or, you know, put a few curls in it, like give it a little more pizzazz. That's the word I'm looking for. So I said, I'm not quite sure how you spell it. So if anybody knows how to spell zhuzh, I even asked Dr. Google, and Dr. Google didn't know what I was saying, actually. Like, what? Okay, so I'm going to use that, and I'm just going to glue that down. And I'm going to use today Art Glitter Glue, and I'm just going to, this is a neat gizmo if you've never seen this. This is a pin to keep that clear. And then I just glued a little magnet. This was recommended by a subby, and boop, there we go. It holds it. I don't have to look for my pin anymore. Isn't that awesome? That is like the best thing since sliced bread. I am like the biggest happy cow in this side of the field. Yep. Okay, here we go. All right. Now you are going to be so pretty on there. All right, there we go. Okay, so. And we can put some other little guys on here just for fun. You look a little lonely. Where was that other page? Here. Oh, you got some cutie birds on here. And I think we could salvage a few of you. I didn't completely just tear apart all of you. Here I am tearing the paper. Loving tearing the paper. That's just one of those things we paper crafters love to do. Tear the paper. All right, there we go. All right, we'll give you a little action with the inker too. How are we on time? Oh, 15, 16 minutes. Okay. It'll put you there. Okay, you want to be there? All right. No problem. You can be there. That's fine with me. All right, I've got the glue left it open, so we will just go ahead and glue you down. All right, we'll put you there. That's all right. No muss, no fuss. And maybe one more for counterbalance, but I think I'm just going to use a twig this time. I'm going to try not to ruin your feet. Sorry about that. Let's get you off of here. I'm just going for the twig effect. Let's see. Any twig-like down in the corner? Here? No. Let's see what I can do. Yeah, maybe something small. Okay, we'll do that. And when you're tearing these little things, try and tear off any sharp pointies. For some reason, I don't know, I just think it looks better without the sharp pointies on it, like right angles and stuff like that. Or triangles that stick out, kind of round it a little bit if you can. Okay, let's see what we got there. That's good. All right, we'll do that. We'll do that because that just feels right. Okay? As long as it makes your heart sing, that's all that matters. Mm-hmm. All right, we'll put you splutch right there. Okay. Okay, so we have our front decorated, and now we're going to massacre it. We're going to cut it up. Cut it up, you say. How could you do that after all that work? Well, because it's just paper, and because it's ours, and we can play with it. So let me roll up my sleeves here, because we're going to do some serious surgery. All right, so we're going to open you up. We're going to grab crafting knife. You can also do this on a guillotine to get nice straight lines. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut this into three sections. Doesn't matter what size they are. Totally up to you. Okay, let's hope this works. Hopefully everything's glued down and dry enough. Go slow, firm. Watch everything. Don't take your eyes off it. Oh, it's sliding a little bit. Okay, that's okay. It's still good. Yep, very good. All right, that was a success. A little scary about cutting him, but it's okay. I think I'm going to have to cut your foot. But your foot will still be there, I promise. It's just going to be on the bottom flapper. All right, hold on. You go slow, steady. Make sure none of your thumbs or anything are hanging over where the scissors are going to be. And retract when you're done. So you don't have to worry about accidentally stabbing yourself. Okay, so now we have our three flappers. How easy is that, right? Everybody's functioning well. Let's get in here with a little bit of extra ink on the inside. And we'll just ink this little edge because that's sort of fun. Maybe we're going to ink these edges because that's always fun. Who can have more fun than us inking, right? You don't have to ink. It's not mandatory. Totally by choice. Optional. You can do other things. You could do faux stitching around the edges. You could do real stitching around the edges. I mean, there's just, you're only limited by your imagination. And that's what we're trying to do here is get your imagination to work a little more. Think about new possibilities and opportunities. And you guys always take my ideas and you make them so much better. You just, you know, it's like that build a better mousetrap. You guys take them and run with them. And I love that because then I get to learn from you. So thank you so much for that. I like to learn too. And okay, so this is choice. You can completely leave it to mask it as if there's no cuts there, or you can emphasize the cuts. And I don't know, I like to emphasize the cuts because I think it gives a tiny clue that something might be going on there, and it might give the journal owner a little indication that maybe there's a little something special under there for them. So I am just going to ink them ever so slightly, and there we have that. Okay, and now we just need to put three little doodads there. And let me take you a little closer. Okay, I found three buttons that I thought I might just place here, or maybe here and here. Yeah, maybe that looks better. Okay, no, we want to go a little further back than that. Oop, there we go. I'll take you a little closer. There we go. All right, so, and I'm just going to glue them down. Nothing fancy. I guess I could, what are we on time? 10, okay. I'm just going to glue them down for time's sake. I just don't want to run out of time. And this one I'm going to use Fabri-Fix. It's a little bit stronger of a glue. It's also good for fabric, but this is button to paper and it's going to grab very well and give me a good strong hold. I could put some threads here through here, which would look really cute. But for time's sake, I'm just going to skip that part. And here we go. And we're gluing. One. And two, and three. Okay, my little glue strings. Works almost just like a hot glue, but it's not hot, it's just room temperature, and that makes it very convenient. No burning at all. Okay, so we have that, and then we're going to work on the inside. So let's pretend that there's a sentiment here. So maybe I'm gonna wanna cover that. And what I can do is I can get a piece of paper. Okay, I just happen to have a piece of stationery, but any paper will do. And we can just put it down here. This has buildings at the top. I don't think that's that related, but it has some plants at the bottom. So that might work. So I'm just going to do this old little trick of measuring to see where it fits perfectly. So I'll just make a little mark for the height where I want to take it to. And then I'll make a little mark where how wide I want it to be. And then I will just cut that. And maybe I will use tearing ruler. Why don't I just use tearing ruler? I'm right here. Okay, you just stay right where you are so I know what you're going to look like. Okay. Oh, okay. No, we don't need you. I can do this without you. Okay. Yeah, sure I can. All right, here we go. Back you up just a little bit. Can you see? Okay. I'm just going to tear. All right. And then I'm just going to tear. Got my little mark down. Oops. Got my little mark down here. Okay. So I'm going to tear it. I hope I'm straight. I'm eyeballing straightness. Looks pretty straight to me. Okay, we'll see how close I was. How close was I? No, I think that's good. That'll work. All right, what I might do is I might just put a little more brown here. And then I might need a little more rebrowning. Rebrown with a walnut stain. I'm just going to emphasize the edges. The torn edge grabs the ink very nicely, and just running around. I've just created a little bluebird there. See that? That's a little bluebird. And that's an oopsie, and my mother used to call them bluebirds. So we will either just make it look, I know what I'll do. What are you doing? Stop. Wait, don't do that. No, I'm not throwing it away. I'm aging it. Yes, I'm just going to give it a little more aging appeal because I've already verdoodled it up. So now I have a wrinkled piece of paper and I have my little bluebird there, but now I'm going to glue the whole puppy down and then we're going to do a little magic to it. Okay, who wants to play? You? Yeah, you can play. All right, you, Art Glitter Glue, you're up. All right, our glitter glue goes for a long time. It's a wet white glue. I mean, it lasts a long time because you've got this little metal nubber on the end of it, and it only dispenses a little amount of glue at a time. All right, so I just want to make sure I have enough glue on here to really hold this down. Make sure I have it around the edges. Edges are important. Okay, any wet white glue will work here. All right, you can use Fabri-Fix as well. Okay, now we're putting it down. Let's see how we do. Okay, now I'm get all the white covered. Okay, now I'm going from the center and I'm working out. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Oop, a little crooked. I have like a second to reposition. Like that was probably too late already. Oh, no, I got 1 second. Okay, 1 second to get that straight. Okay, I did not bad. It's not perfect, but not bad. But now here I'm going to, here's my little trick to, here, look at that. I put wrinkles in the paper, and now when I lightly go over it with my ink dauber, it'll pick up all that, and you know, you can't even, like, the bluebird is the last thing you're worried about at that point, because you just have this beautiful aged paper here. And I really like that, so I'm very happy with that. And now these I have, they're more clean and pristine, and I think what I will do, where my time was, okay, is I am going to put a stencil. And that's a fun way to zhuzh it up. And okay, so let's do some zhuzhing. All right, I could do the same color, different color. 5 minutes, maybe I'll do same color. Yeah, okay. All right. Oh, I could probably do a different color too. I'm going crazy. I just feel like I want a little green in here too. Okay, this is just like a softy green. Okay, oh, stuck, help. Okay, still looking good, still looking good. Maybe I'll turn it over. Do a little bit like this. Do, 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 do. I do have this green stencil down below. This is a specialty stencil I got somewhere. A little pricier than the rest, but if you really want a green stencil, or a green a tree stencil, it's a pretty one. And I've used this a lot. I like it a lot. Okay. All right, so we have that. See, voila, now we have that. And now it's just up to us to do what we want with it. We could put words here, here, and here, and let's try that. All right, so I have some old... Let's just whip these out here and see what I have. I have these old magazines. Oh, how about something about, is it your beautiful morning? That's like from a Yardley ad, and I like that. I'm gonna grab that. See, they don't have to be related to nature, but it sounds nature related when you're looking at birdies on the front and stuff like that. Okay, so I have one, and I need two more. Not motor history. Let's see, I'll find it. Don't give up on me. Cool as a trout in a pool. Oh, maybe I could use in a pool. That's something sort of nature related. We'll put you as a maybe. What do we have here? Every piece an heirloom. Old English, inviting you to breakfast. Okay, we have possibilities there. Mary had a vision in 1851. And what else do we have? Cellular brain, so light. How about so light? Yeah, birds are light. I can do that. Light as a feather, right? Right? That's a thing. All right, here we go. And I just need one more. What have I got? For the homes and palaces of the world. No, no. All right, we're back to the pool. How about in a pool? Yeah, birds could be in a small pool, like a bird bath, right? Yeah. Or maybe I'll put a sticker there or something. I don't know yet. Let's see. But they're all kind of water-related nature. I could fudge that, sure. Okay, so let's see what we got. All right, we're good, we're good, we're good. And that's what I'm saying, one of those like triangles, I would just like round that off a little bit more. And it'll just look a little softer. And get your inker dinker. Maybe I'll just use a different color for the heck of it. Just make it look a little different because I'm going to be putting it on this brown paper. And you could leave this blank if you want to just leave it for journaling space, which is also very beautiful and not mandatory to do anything about it. Okay. Is it your beautiful morning? I need more ink. I am using worn lipstick. I'm good. I am going to complete this mission on time, intact, and be ready to carry on for the next mission. All right, this is so cool. Okay, there we go. We got this one. Going around the mountain to... Okay, there's one of those triangles. I'm get rid of you. I made two more. All right, that's okay. Oh, good grief. All right, here we go. Oh, I got 17 triangles there now, but you know what I mean. You know, you can leave the little triangles too. There's one, so get rid of it. Okay, got it. Okay. So light. In a pool. And like, so what I'm trying to get across the idea of is look in magazines because you can find bigger font, bigger text to play with. And sometimes when you're just looking for something fun, you don't have to have a million rubber stamps and stuff. Just have to have a little ingenuity. Maybe these look better over here, huh? Yeah, I think so. All right, so I'm just going to stick them over there. I totally changed my mind. They pop more over here. I think that's what it is. Maybe if I would have used white writing over here, it would look better. But I think I'm going to put them here, which is just completely different from the plan. But, you know, sometimes you just change your mind at the last minute. And, you know, who's to say? You know, the crafting police are not going to come in and take you away. So it's going to be all right. You just go ahead and craft. Craft to your heart's content, you know. And just make sure you have fun. And if you get inspired to do something, I highly encourage you to just do it. Just drop everything and do it, because, you know, you'll try and remember it and you'll say, oh, I'll try that next time. And it's gone. It's gone. Like the wind flew through your brain and that whole idea and all the thrill of it is gone too. So I say, grab, seize the moment, carpe diem, and just create it right then. If it wasn't for you, it would have never been born. And, you know, you may end up loving it. And wouldn't that be awesome? So here we go. All right. There we go. Oh, you know what I could do? I got 3 minutes left. I could find one more bird there or something. I have these little babies. They're kind of cute. And they're just sitting here doing nothing. Why don't we put you there? Yeah, I just feel like you need something. And this will look nice because it's in the white too. Did I do the back? Yeah. All right, so we can say we are good with that. Okay, I got a few little corners there, but that's okay. Let me just maybe go on pink as well, because we're just bringing in a little pink here for the heck of it. And we are done gluing. And so just wrapping things up here, if you found value here, please like, subscribe, and share. And let's see, I'm on Pinterest, Instagram, Facebook. Come check out the Facebook group. And I've got a podcast going. It's on Apple and Spotify and Google. And let's just put that there to say we did. And let's see what this looks like now. Okay, so we have this, and this opens there. We have that. Oh, what's that? You could put like maybe a word or some decorations here. And then we have this little surprise showing there. And then we have that. And here is our back. And we could, you know, do more on the back too as well. Let's see. Maybe I'll put a stamp on the back. I think I have a stamp right here. Here it is. Okay. I got a stamp. I don't exactly know what it is, but I think it's a flower. It was just the first one that I grabbed. Put you right there. Okay, we weren't that dark. Maybe I'll color him in later. Nope, got another bluebird. You know how that goes. Dirty fingers. But there, you can have some ideas like that. You know what? I'm going to do a little stenciling on there. I'm not going to say that's okay. I'm just going to keep going until the time disappears. And I just stop talking because my video thing shut me down. That's right. This is how you hide your bluebirds. Okay, there. My bluebird's gone. Didn't even know it was there now, right? Okay, see that? See that? That's how it's done. And the bluebird is gone. It's just in the forest, in the trees with everybody else. So there you go, folks. I hope you like this. I'll show you these others so you can see them again. And I can't find the other one, but it's here somewhere. And here it is. And these were a lot of fun to make. I hope you make them. Give them a try. Have fun. Happy crafting. Remember that fun can be simple and you can create with reckless abandon and have a total blast. Take care, everyone. Bye.